of smoke on. He dives down. With a 25-meter pylon, wings must be level through gate one. Perfect entry and perfect start for Murphy. Gate two, quick turn between, into the chicane. Smooth but quick. Into the chicane for the first time. This is where he tightens his race line. Now,
pulled on the stick with the half Cuban turnout. Let me put that into perspective, ladies and gentlemen.
On some of the toughest tracks around the world, our pilots here today pulling 10 to 12 G every time they pull that stick back. It looks aggressive, but it takes a lot of skill. It must be a smooth maneuver to keep the plane traveling through the air cleanly, and of course too aggressive, and that plane will stall at the top of the DTM. See the smoke. Follow the smoke of the plane through the track. If the smoke is smooth and not broken, that means he's flying the optimum racing line. Remember, this is not about looking pretty, it's about going fast.
Vertical turn maneuver. Watch the half human turn from the plane to bring the green
in a westerly direction, looking for that second BTM. If he pulls too hard and aggressively on the stick, he'll stall the plane. There'll be no air to support the wing. So it needs to be smooth. One arc maneuver from the Italian pilot. Remember, Costa now is thinking about beating that 51-second time on Ben Murphy. There's the smoke. That's the communication from the race tower. And if this were a fully blown world championship race right now, of course we'd have 14 pilots going through a round of 14, round of 8, and into the final four. But for our demonstration purposes today, look at Murphy, 20 meters off the ground.
put it really high on the RPM. 12G half turn Cuban back into the track.
And completely different to Ben in his Red Arrow day. Now comes to the end of the Western.
Do aerobatics in a helicopter, quite unique skill. The guys who are qualified to fly the infrared ball doing the aerobatic routine are very skillful pilots. Other things the helicopter's being used for is the fast one. How about that? Other things the helicopter's been used, rescue flights, lead and tank helicopters, VIP transport, but not doing that with a VIP transport. Beam service, 35 countries around the world. Where else would it be?
I want to see more of that.
Yeah, hey.